Good morning, students. Our topic is regulation of gene expression. We know that all the metabolic activities are governed by different enzymes, and enzymes are produced or under the control of genes. But the thing is that genes do not express or produces enzymes all the time. When a particular enzyme is required, then the relevant gene become active. The gene that is responsible to produce that particular enzyme, then it become active and increases the formation of enzymes. We are taking here the example of bacteria, which regulates the synthesis of enzymes in such a way that enzymes are produced. That the most important, the enzymes are produced when the substrate on which these enzymes have to act. Means the enzymes, they become active when the substrate is present on which it acts and converts into a simplest form and releases energy. If the substrate is present, then the enzymes are formed, or the gene express itself give the message to the messenger RNA. And this messenger, that is the transcription process occurs, and the messenger RNA, which has taken the coded message, translate into a particular enzyme, and then enzyme take parts in the other, acts on the substrate and forms the simplest protein. So for just to explain this content, Jacob and Menot, that Jacob and Menot, they produced a mechanism, and that mechanism is called as a operon hypothesis, or maybe called as the lac operon. They studied the regulation of gene on the metabolism of E. coli. What they have taken? They have taken the bacteria for their experiment as E. coli, Escherichia coli. Now they have taken the segment of DNA thus named as operon. The segment of DNA named as operon, and they divided their experiment into two form parts. First part is called as inducible operon, and second is called as repressible operon. These two are differentiated by in the form that in this experiment they have added lactose, that is the substrate, and in this repressor operon they do not use or add a substrate, that is lactose. Here that inducible operon, first operon, that is this operon is switched on when a substrate is or the inducer is present. Substrate or inducer is present. Substrate may be called as a inducer, which initiates the formation of the enzyme, just the genes, and activates the genes. So the most important thing is then that the genes do not express itself or produces enzyme all the time. When the substrate is present, when the body is required, the substrate is present, and that substrate is now act or initiate the process of transcription, that is the they activates the enzyme. As we know that that they have taken the operon, that is the DNA segment, and on the DNA segments the genes are present. Genes are responsible to give rise to different enzyme, or and the different parts of different genes are located on the segment of DNA, and they named as regulator gene, promoter gene, operator gene, and the structural gene. The enzyme RNA polymerase, as already we have discussed in our transcription process, that RNA polymerase is responsible to transcript the process. So here the RNA polymerase is very important, and the inducer, that is lactose, is also very important, which acts as a substrate. Again thing, the lactose or the substrate is also very important in this experiment. So that now in this inducible operon, Lactose of E. coli is an example of inducer represented as I also here. Then regulator gene, they gives the message to messenger RNA with this message in coded form, and they forms a repressor. They forms a repressor, and they added substrate also, and that substrate is called as inducer. Repressor and the inducer bind together and forms a complex structure and inhibits to bind with the operator gene. Here, as the inducer binds with the repressor and inhibits to move towards the operator region. That's why the RNA polymerase, it attaches to the promoter region, gave the direction information to the operator, then to the structural gene, and the transcription process occur. The messenger RNA taken the coded message from the DNA segment, that is structural gene, and converts the enzyme and forms the enzyme beta galactosidase, permease, and transacylatylase. These three different enzymes are formed because in the presence of the substrate lactose. Then that the important function of these different enzymes are as follows here, that beta galactosidase, these are the enzymes which catalyzes the lactose into glucose and galactose. That important thing, beta galactosidase, that is the enzyme, are responsible to catalyze lactose into glucose and galactose. While the permease, it helps to carry the lactose molecule into the cell. That permease, it carry the different number of lactose molecule into the cell. While the third, transacetylase, it helps to activate lactose. Now that the whole process completed here, that transcription also done here, and the translation process is also done to forms the, converts the lactose into glucose and galactose, which is required to the, required by the E. coli. Then it means that lactose, we can say that act as an inducer of its own kind. As the lactose is converted into glucose, so lactose acts as an inducer in its own kind. And the most important thing is that small amount of lactose permease, small amount of lactose permease is always present in the cell. And this initiates the process because lactose permease, it helps to take the molecule of lactose into the cell. So in this process, inducible operon, the formation of enzymes are taking place and the gene express themselves by producing enzymes, beta galactosidase, transacetylase, and permease. Now in the second, in the operon, that is the repressible operon, now they, the situation is that, condition is that these experiment has done in the absence of lactose. There was no lactose or the substrate. Again the DNA segment with the regulator gene, promoter gene, operator gene, and the structural gene, the same process, this is a continuous process. Regulator gene may be called as the inhibitor gene because it inhibits, it produces repressor and it inhibits the process of transcription or the expression of gene. So that the regulator gene can have taken the message from the DNA segment and by the messenger RNA forms the repressor. This is the repressor, may be called as the inhibitor, and there is no inducer, there is no lactose, that's why it moves towards the operator and block the passage to, and the RNA polymerase which is over here, we attaches to the promoter gene area, it is not able to convey the message to the, or add the, what is the formation function of RNA polymerase, to add the nucleoside triphosphate. But here that the condition is the passage is blocked by that repressor. That's why the message is not conveyed towards the structural gene, and there was no transcription and no translation. So in this way, the genes, they are not able to express themselves, and there was no transcription and translation. So in this way, they prove that all the time the genes are not expressed themselves.